We begin tonight with a bombshell book by Michael Wolff, which paints a stunning picture of dysfunction in the Trump campaign and White House and contains stunning quotes from Steve Bannon, who is, let's remember, the president's former top political advisor, his campaign mastermind, the one who stood by him when no one else would, even when the Access Hollywood tape hit. Now it seems Bannon has turned on his old boss, Bannon on the record, saying things implicating him in the Russia probe and that suggests Trump's oldest son and son-in-law committed treason. And yet for all that, Bannon told Michael Wolff for the new book, Fire and Fury Inside the Trump White House, it's only part of the picture Wolff paints of the president, how he operates, and a White House under fire. Wolff says he based the book on conversations and interviews with most members of President Trump's senior staff, even the president himself. According to Wolff's book, here's what Steve Bannon said about the June 2016 Trump Tower meeting between Russians promising dirt on Hillary Clinton, Donald Trump Jr., son-in-law Jared Kushner, and campaign chairman Paul Manafort. Quote, the three senior guys in the campaign thought it was a good idea to meet with a foreign government inside Trump Tower in the conference room on the 25th floor with no lawyers. They didn't have any lawyers. Even if you thought that this was not treasonous or unpatriotic or bad expletive, and I happen to think it's all of that, you should have called the FBI immediately. Bannon said more on that subject, and we'll get to that. But first, though, keeping him honest, the White House disputes much of the book. But what's really interesting is the White House line of attack on Steve Bannon now, which seems to be exactly what they've done time after time, insisting that the person in question never really was much of a player after all. They did it with Paul Manafort. They did it with George Papadopoulos. They did it with Michael Flynn. They did it with Carter Page. And now listen to what they're saying about Steve Bannon. The president said, in part, Steve Bannon has nothing to do with me or my presidency. When he was fired, he not only lost his job, he lost his mind. Sarah Sanders was asked about that today.
The president's statement suggests that Steve Bannon had very little influence in the White House, but the president himself elevated him to the same level as the chief of staff and put him on the National Security Council. How do you reconcile that?
I wouldn't say that he elevated him to the same level of the chief of staff, and I think that in the actions that Steve took, the president was clear that it didn't have a lot of influence on him or the decision-making process throughout his time here at the White House.
Okay, so Sarah Sanders saying that the president's former campaign CEO and then chief White House political strategist did not have a lot of influence. Let's just look at some pictures to begin. Look, there's Steve Bannon one-on-one with the president. Take another look. There's Steve Bannon exercising his walk-in privileges at a meeting in the Oval Office. Oh, look, there's Steve Bannon with members of the president's national security team. And even after he left the White House, Steve Bannon continued to speak with the president.
A very quick one, which is I just don't understand the timing of something. Steve Bannon left in the summer, late summer. If the president says he lost his mind when he left, why did he continue to talk to him for so many months?
That's a good question. Press Secretary Sarah Sanders answered by suggesting there was nothing irreconcilable about those two irreconcilable notions.
Look, the president continued to have conversations with him, often asked for by Mr. Bannon. The president spoke with him, but that doesn't mean that he can't hold that position.
So she's saying that the president of the United States is having conversations with someone that he believes has lost his mind. Let that sink in. And while you do that, as for Sanders' claim that Bannon and Chief of Staff Reince Priebus were not on equal footing, which is what Sarah Sanders said today, here is the press release naming them to their jobs. Listen to the wording, please. President-elect Donald J. Trump today announced that Trump for President CEO Stephen K. Bannon will serve as chief strategist and senior counselor to the president, and Republican National Committee Chairman Reince Priebus will serve as White House chief of staff. Bannon and Priebus will continue the effective leadership team they formed during the campaign, working as equal partners to transform the federal government. Equal partners, Reince Priebus, Steve Bannon, transforming the federal government together as equal partners, despite what Sarah Sanders said today. Again, the White House disputes much of what came out in excerpts in this new book by Michael Wolff. Sarah Sanders, today.
We're certainly happy for people that have different opinions, but there's a difference between different opinions and different facts. And people are entitled to an opinion, but they're not entitled to their own facts. And we have a big problem with people putting out misleading information. Those are very different things.
Sarah Sanders, today, talking about people putting out misleading information. Let that one sink in for a moment.